talk about it still too much, and like I always feel kind of awkward when people ask questions because I don't know all the answers about why he's dead sometimes. But yeah, it's tremendous, you know, just as a person, first and foremost, you know, the way that he conducts himself is someone that, you know, I've always looked up to and tried to emulate. You know, obviously his toughness was something that I always really admired and tried to aspire to be like. You know, you hear all the kind of legendary stories, I guess, about how hard he was able to push himself. And so, you know, for him to tell me, you know, how tough he thinks I am, you know, that was one of the biggest compliments I've ever gotten in my life. But just to have someone who's been through it all, you know, he knows what it's like to run these races, he knows what it's like to train for these races, and, you know, everything that he looks at, like all the mistakes he made were almost to serve a purpose for his athletes now. And so it's like, I just feel so lucky to have someone like that who is, you know, overdid it himself and learned so much from his own career, learned what worked, what didn't work, and to be able to be the beneficiary, you know, of all those kind of hard lessons to go through has been huge. And it's a huge confidence booster when you have someone who's a world record holder that, you know, has won major marathons. And when he says you're ready, you know, your training's been better than anything he's done. You know, you gain a ton of confidence from that heading into a race. So it's always good to have someone like that in your corner.
When you're in the midst of the race and you're starting to feel that fatigue, how do you get the power to help you, especially over and over again?
Oh, they're huge. You know, I mean, you know, they do a great job cheering for everybody, but no doubt they get a little extra room when Americans come by. You know, I think we've seen that with some of the past Americans.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, it's the support is just tremendous. You know, I think if anything, you have to be a little careful not to get too amped up or too caught up in it, because it is so great for the whole way. You know, I was amazed last year for 26 miles. It's four or five people at least deep lining the course and cheering hard. So you have to kind of make sure you stay calm, especially in the beginning. And, you know, it's easy to get carried away sometimes when you hear how forcefully they're cheering you on. You know, it makes you want to push harder, but you know, you can't get too hyped up too early, and let that be, you know, it can be a negative, you know, if you push too hard and then you're just shot by the end. You know, that was something that be cognizant of, but when you're hurting at those last little bits, they certainly carry it.
It's really cool to see now at night, you see the lights from all the houses in the west hill,
and there's
a deadline, everything else is fourth part, completely dark, so that's really cool to see.
You know what? We addressed all this stuff like 2 years ago. I know what I've done. I know all the hard work that I've put in, and I've always followed the water code and done everything by the book. And so, you know, I'm extremely proud of all that I've accomplished. And you know, once we addressed it 2 years ago, it's really easy to move forward. You know, again, you know, I've done nothing wrong. I always followed the water code, and so it's easy once you do that and you have that truth behind you to address it. You know, obviously, and then you move forward. My focus has always been on this race, and things have gone really well, so I'm excited for it. Thank you so much.
Have you gone back and watched last year's race?
Huh?
Have you gone back and watched last year's race?
I don't know if I have. Yeah, I don't think I have. Yeah, no. You know, we always do a big review after every season, which for me now is just the marathon, basically. You know, you do one in the spring and one in the fall, but you know, it's something that my coaches have always stressed, is to really go back and put it on paper and look at. Be a real honest evaluation of how you did, you know, what didn't work, what did work in a lot of different areas, whether that's, you know, physically, mentally, in the training, you know, how well you're recovering, sleeping, all this stuff. That's something that I've always done, you know, going back to college. So even though I didn't watch it, you know, I really spent a lot of time reflecting on it, and you know, I think that's ultimately how you get better, is how you really take a critical look at yourself, and you know, you have to. It can't just be in your head, you know. I think sometimes as time goes on, you can kind of remember things a little differently than they actually happened. Or, you know, if you have a good result, you remember it feeling great and that it was never hard. But, you know, things are always
required by a lot of carry.
You always go through rough patches and races, and so it's important to really, you know, take that honest look and be critical of yourself and then learn from those mistakes and grow from it.
Do you consider last year's race a rough patch, getting second here?
I wouldn't say it was rough. I mean, I was very happy with the the way I ran, don't get me wrong. You know, I guess it was frustrating knowing that I didn't have a real proper build-up, and I missed so much time and was missing so much strength just because I wasn't able to train like I normally would. So I guess it was a little frustrating in that regard, but at the same time, I was so excited and so thrilled mentally the way I ran, you know, given that you never want to start a race, you know, especially a race like the Boston Marathon, where you know you haven't done the work, and you know that you're just kind of relying on talent. You know, that's not a way you ever want to go into a race. So I was real pleased with the way mentally that I held it together, and you know, despite all the setbacks I had going up, that I still was able to, you know, perform really well in that race and execute, you know, despite all that. So you know, there's obviously some things I had to learn from, you know, and learn from. The biggest thing I think was in the hills, just not pushing. I got a little too excited, and I probably would have died anyway at the end because I didn't have the strength. But pushing too hard in those hills really just killed me for the last 5 or 6 miles, and I had nothing to respond when Jeffrey made his move last year. So you know, that was a big lesson that I took forward. You know, that I applied to Chicago. You know, we made the adjustments. Hopefully, we'll be all right for another way around.
And this is the first time we're returning to marathon.
It's a little weird, you know. I've never actually before Monday, I've never seen a full course before I run. You know, I think I jogged the last 2 miles in Chicago, jogged the last mile in Rio and LA. I ran the last 400 or 800 meters of the finish line, but I've never actually seen a full course before I've run it. So it's good though. I think it definitely will help here. You know, this is such a unique course with all the downhills and, you know, the fact that it's point to point. It just is. There's a lot more that this course throws at you than a lot of major marathon courses do. So I think that experience is going to be big for me on Monday.
And last year,
it's been great. You know, this has been the best marathon buildup I've ever had, you know, for any race. You know, I've been real happy with the way that, you know, first and foremost, I've just been healthy and been able to run hard. But I've done more mileage on a weekly basis for a long period of time, you know, 8, 10, 12 weeks. You know, that's where you really see those strength gains. And I've done more than I ever have for that period. And I've been able to keep doing all the speed work that I think is important to succeed in the marathon, which, you know, for me, it's been hard when I've done high mileage in the past. And I think that's just kind of... it's a testament to the real long-term plan that I've had. You know, I think I'm just getting older, and I've done, you know, had this long gradual build-up where every year you keep trying to do more and more, and now I'm at a point where I think my body's able to handle that mileage more, and my workouts don't really suffer as a result. So I'm real excited to see how that all plays out on Monday.
So what kind of mileage do you get?
I don't want to give like a specific number, but it's been a lot, you know, well more than I've ever done before.
And you've been healthy, but Jordan has had a plantar issue. Is there anything that you told her to help her get through it?
You know, the only thing I really told her was, you know, it's kind of funny, but we're in kind of the same boat, you know, as I was last year. You know, I just told her, you know, I know it's stressful, it's tremendously frustrating to be dealing with an injury, you know, especially before, you know, a big marathon like this, but, you know, I missed a lot of time. You know, she really was able to get in all the key workouts that she needed to, and she has such a better training background than I had leading up to this race last year. So, you know, it's hard. I think the biggest thing is just psychologically, you got to hang in there and try to stay positive and, you know, keep trying everything to get as good as you can. You know, there's a lot of things you can do with working with inserts or, you know, to take the stress off your planner. And it's frustrating when things don't work, but you have to just try to stay positive and keep moving forward with that. And, you know, just always remember that you have a tremendous training base behind you that I didn't have last year. And, so she'll be ready to go, I think, on Monday. And, you know, she's been feeling good, and I think she's done a really good job handling it all.
Thanks a lot.
All right, anytime.